I'm gonna leave that with me, okay? No regrets in this speech tonight. Please give a warm welcome to distinguished Toastmaster Carmelo Velardo III.
When I was a kid, in my house, life was rough. No matter what happened, no matter what was going on, it could have been the best of times. There was usually a Cat 5 hurricane coming towards us. And sometimes, it seemed almost impossible that we would ever get out of that situation. And that was kind of normal for me as a kid. And the number one culprit that caused all those issues was my father. And I swore as I grew and grew that I would never be like my father. Then after years into my own experience as a father myself, I realized so much of what I was my father. That was a tough, tough day. In that time, some damage was done, obviously, in my mind. And I used to beat myself up for this every day. It was guilt. Lots of guilt. I used to wake up in the middle of the night thinking, oh my God, what have I done? Mr. Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters and guests, in 20 plus years of being a father, I still kick myself sometimes. However, I've grown to believe that things happen for a reason, even things we don't understand. And this is sometimes very hard to swallow. I wouldn't be who I am today without the experiences, being able to consider and understand current situations that I'm experiencing or something that just happened. I'm proud that I'm able to stop and evaluate stuff. Did I handle that well? Could I have done that differently? How can I do better next time? Sometimes I get really angry and react impetuously. And most of the time, I regret it. But I reevaluate and I decide that the next time that situation or something like that comes, I'm going to handle it differently. And it usually happens that way because I'm aware of it. It's called stopping and thinking and acting instead of reacting. One of the biggest lessons that I've learned in my life is if you make a mistake or if you mess up, to own it, look it right in the eye, look yourself right in the eye. Like Michael Jackson said, the man in the mirror. Apologize if you have to, and do it quickly, even publicly if you need to. Last week, I did something that I thought would be beneficial to everybody. It backfired, and in a not so subtle way, I was informed of this, and a person was excuse me. Can't say the word "and" apparently. A person was affected negatively, completely the opposite of what I had intended. And This was made known to me in a public setting, a group, people that respect me. And I began to get defensive because in my house, that's what we did to survive. And it was all about survival. However, I quickly realized, and that's the key, quickly, like a light switch, turning the light on in a room. I quickly realized that I had to own it, and I apologized publicly. And then everything was okay. Everyone was okay. Here, in this experience in life, we can dig ourselves so deeply into our own righteousness. It's our ego. The heck with that other situation. It's my ego I have to protect. So much so that we're unable to look in any other direction. We dig ourselves so deep, we can't move to the right, to the left, forward, or backward. But we can be flexible. Flexible enough to be educated by our own experiences and the experiences of others. This will help us in every aspect of our life, especially our relationships. What is one of the biggest lessons in my life? No regrets. Just opportunities to be better. Are you open to opportunity?